dart trading here now, guys. 75 even dart trading. 4 even. 3 even dart trading here. 2 even dart trading. 72 even just traded. Once again, guys, we are...
On Thursday, May 6, 2010, the S&P 500 futures opened at 1164.25. Little did the world know, this would mark the beginning of a tumultuous and mysterious event. As the clock ticked away, a young man sitting in his mother's home began executing trades with precision. Protests have been happening in Greece, and the situation became increasingly volatile. The UK was also facing an impending election, making the markets extremely vulnerable. Vidal and Reed, a US-based hedge fund, had a simple algorithm in place. Sell 9% of the volume traded on the year's futures in the previous minute at the end of every minute. However, they had a glitch in the system. They forgot to put the code to mention the limits of these transactions. This action, combined with the already unstable political and economic climate, would lead to a catastrophic event in the global financial market. By 14:00 EST, the markets began to rapidly hit the bids, creating a massive downward move. High-end stocks like P&G went down 25% in under a minute. The market rebounded within minutes, but the chaos had already been set in motion. Investigation followed, and the initial accusations aimed at Vidal and Reed and Fat Finger errors. But within 5 months, the CFTC came out with a report stating that the crash was due to massive directional bets and heavy selling. As the dust settled, a curious quant trader decided to backtest the flash crash. Quant traders have ability to use data, along with research tools like backtesting, forward testing, and Monte Carlo simulations. This gives them massive edges compared to other retail traders who focus just on fundamentals and technicals. Quant traders can find strategies designed for any environments, including recessionary environments. Here's an example of a strategy that was successful both last year and in 2008. This specific quant trader decided to download all the information on bids and offers on that unique day. What he saw was something so strange: the high amount of cancelled orders. This was done over 100,000 times during and prior to the flash crash. This is where we introduce what spoofing is. Spoofing is a methodology where a trader places a substantially large limit order, giving the illusion of massive demand or supply for a product, but with no intention of executing it. For example, if Apple is trading at $10, the trader places a limit order at, say, $12 for 1,000 lots, creating an illusion that there are lots of sellers. When the market trades around $11, he'll cancel that $12 order. The quant trader then sent all this information to CFTC, leading to an investigation. The investigation revealed some interesting findings regarding a retail trader in London, Navinder Singh Sarao, who made close to $40 million by automating his strategies. The CFTC arrested Navinder and extradited him to the US to face charges. He initially faced 22 charges that could carry a maximum sentence of 380 years. Spoofing was not illegal in the UK at that time, but it was in the US. Navinder paid a fine of $12 million and prosecutors decided not to push for a jail sentence due to the fact that he lost most of his money in poor investments, and he was willing to help the investigators in the future. The story of Navinder is something that is extremely mysterious. Just like many of the traders, Nav started his career by doing a course in a proprietary trading firm in London called Futex. He learned many of the techniques in order flow and started performing well. He was known in the trading floor as extremely quiet and humble and treated the trading markets like a video game. After his training and initial success, he went on to create his own small company called Nav Sarao Futures Limited. It was just a one-person company which operated from his home. With the amount of leverage that one could get in futures trading, he started using this to his advantage by spoofing consistently. This is extremely hard to be done manually on a daily basis. The potential to make money is huge if automated. He then hired a quant as he didn't have any coding experience. In this case, a quantitative developer, i.e. a coder. The coder was from a company called Edge Financial Technologies and was paid an estimated $24,000 for the algorithm. However, the company and the coder was cleared of any charges as they weren't directly involved in the execution of the strategy. In fact, the attorney telling the jury that accusing the coder was like accusing a phone salesman for somebody committing a crime over phone. The spoofing strategy on the day of the flash crash made almost $900,000. Overall, between 2010 to 2014, Nav made $42 million. It is also unknown whether he used other strategies along with this. With the rise in quantitative traders around the world, the speed and behavior of the strategies and the markets has changed considerably well. The volatility of the past few years is significant as compared to 10 years ago. Post the arrest of Nav, many changes were brought into the financial market. CFTC and many other countries decided to ban spoofing and other practices like front-running. However, it is unknown if exchanges around the world have this rule and if traders are still using this strategy. Many of the exchanges don't have the technological infrastructure to identify these kind of orders as the volumes of the exchanges have increased considerably. The amount of retail traders now in the market is substantially higher than in 2010. Even after all the accusations, there has been studies that prove that Nav alone couldn't have caused the crash. It was possibly a combination of events and Nav's algorithm just being one of those events that contributed to the possible crash, similar to a butterfly effect, in which a small change in one state can result in large differences in a later state. The phrase refers to the idea that a butterfly's wings might create tiny changes in the atmosphere that may ultimately alter the path of a tornado or delay it. In the case of Nav's, the big spoof order creating a panic in the market which forced some traders to sell more and that putting the market down further, which created a chain reaction of even more sellers and stop orders being hit. Questions were raised against HFT firms as well. Were they not doing the same thing, finding quantitative edges and executing orders so fast that normal traders couldn't compete? The flash crash till this day remains shrouded in mystery and uncertainty. Flash crash also happened multiple times since. The currency market has also been affected, such as British pound in 2016, the Japanese yen in 2019, and even the European stocks recently in May 2nd, 2022. It is estimated that at least 12 mini flash crashes occur every day. This means that we will never know when the next big one will happen. The question is, are the systems prepared for such a move with many retail traders involved? Social media being active so much these days can add fuel to the fire. Are the retail traders prepared? Maybe it will be one of the new quant retail traders that could trigger another event.